empathize with students. They are my young friends. I am with them. But when you choose a country to go and study, you have to look at geopolitics. You have to look at all the situations around. So Uday, will a person like you or me or anybody choose today to employment in China or Pakistan? If you choose, it's your own risk and it's on your own peril. That's the point number one. So my, you know, request here to all the parents have to be, please be very, very careful before you decide to send your kids out for education. You have to be alive and you have not to be naive about the geopolitics of the thing. Look at a country. You're sending your kid to a country called China. Look at Tiananmen Square. This country crushes 1,000 or 10,000 of its people under tanks. Huh? Tank ke niche. In broad daylight, that is what is the value of a student, a Chinese, Han Chinese student in China. Forget our ma'am, sir. They don't even count for them. This is a political game played by CCP to put down India, to put pressure on the Modi government, to put to try to somehow seed a kind of a student revolution, wherein some people will tomorrow come that, you know, 20,000-23,000 students are falling prey to Modi's tactics. It's because of the app ban, they are not allowed to participate in the Chinese things. If China would have wanted, they could have given them alternate technologies. There are so many of them today which can even talk to each other. Why on the ban Chinese are solely because they want to send a message here, they want to create a ruckus here, they want to incite student community of the India and they want to show how bad the Indian government is. It's a political game, Uday. Why did I pick Tiananmen Square? Because if this is the attitude of China to its own students, apne bachcho ke liye attitude hai, forget ours, forget what can happen to them there. Now coming to the solution is very simple, Uday. You know, we have 542 medical colleges here and we around 76,000 students pass out every year. So if we look at the number and if we look at this number, it would be 40 students per medical college. We can start online courses for them. We can start some, you know, off-hour courses for them and settle this issue. But at the same time, let's let the government of India issue a list. These are the recommended countries. These are non-recommended countries. I want to bring one more issue, right? Very soon we'll have the same debate on Pakistan. There are a lot of students are going to Pakistan. On the whole earth, you get to go to Pakistan, Islamabad, Lahore to study what? I mean, this kind of things will happen in today's geopolitics. You cannot be good. To create some kind of a student unrest in India and show to the world how Modi's government is, ban is impacting its own 20,000 students. That's the whole thing. Look, Uday, what have they done tonight? They have duped Nike. If they could dupe a fertile brain like Elon Musk, you know what is the story of Tesla? We debated on Netflix. Now, these are the latest victims of the Chinese, you know, atrocities. Now, if they are doing what they can do to Uyghurs, they can do a Tiananmen Square. Why do you think they are not politically capable of doing this? Creating issues and trouble where do not exist. The only solution, I think, is today with the hostilities of China, are these students willing to sign a declaration if something untoward happens to them? That is their own responsibility. Because in my opinion, I don't even think it is safe for them to go there, forget Chinese vaccine or Indian vaccine. Chinese vaccine has 73 known fatal effects. Who takes the responsibility? If these 20,000 kids land there tomorrow, if they're used as a bargaining chip, I'll be as candid as that. Who takes the responsibility for that? The only solution is, you know, if you divide them over 542 medical colleges we have, 40 students per medical college, do an online class and complete their course. I would not recommend as an individual, as a, you know, a contributor to send them to China because it's a very dangerous country over there. Let's not forget Tiananmen Square, Uday, if they can crush their own people under tax. Hamara ki kya aukaat hai? You know, what will they think about us? If Chinese Communist Party can stoop to this level and show this to the world, now I want to ask these people who want to go and do business in China. I want to ask these people who want to set up factories in China. I want to ask these people who want to say, oh, China is the biggest market. This is what China is about, from Elon Musk to Nike to students. How low can you stoop? How niche, kitna niche giro gaya? And Uday, I strongly recommend that the government of India comes up with a recommended list of countries. These are the countries where we recommend your kids can go. Because government is not sending them, they're going on their own. And anything beyond the recommended list is your own risk, is your own liability. Geopolitics is changing, India is emerging, we have a lot of people who are hostile to us. What about these kids who are going to Pakistan? Tomorrow you might have a hostage execution in Pakistan. How do I know this? When these kids reach there, we don't end up into hostage execution. Who knows that? Who can guarantee that? With CCP, who has killed 6 million of its own people, Great Leap Forward and the Cultural Revolution, where you kill just 6 million of your own people. What is the guarantee with Chinese? Who takes the guarantee? Kaun guarantee lega, sir? That is the bigger question. Forget, you know, the app ban, forget the vaccine. we will teach them here, we have to find a way to accommodate here. I am more worried about their safety, security once they land in China. I am asking and appealing to the parents, are you willing to risk your child to be sent? If it's my kid, I'm not going to send. Uday, how many of us will take a job in a China or Pakistan? Why? Because you know the problem. You know the problem, you know the hostilities on ground. You have seen Afghan ambassador's daughter getting kidnapped. If these things are happening in these dangerous countries, 20,000 kids is a big number. I'm never ever in favor of sending them to China. Find an alternate solution, and these kids should also understand they are at vulnerable. They can be used as a politically bargaining chip. They can be taken hostages. Let them not do it. Find a way, work with the government, complete your online sessions or whatever. And after that, we kiss goodbye to China and Pakistan for good.
You know, that can be, of course, perhaps looked at later. But, for a